Robert Morales, LA News. Blake looked really good out there today, had a few high-flying dunks. How would you assess your performance, and do you feel like you're getting closer to being Blake Griffin?
I felt really good. I mean, our offense was really clicking. I think we thought we were doing the things that we wanted to do. And that helps, you know. We get easy shots, and I got some ones right at the basket early, so that helps. Pretty close to how I want to feel.
Okay. Josh was saying it helped that you were able to get off to a good start. Now, How did the start feel for you, and was it different from some of your recent games?
It felt good. Just like I said, you know, we got to the things we wanted to do early. So getting those easy baskets, getting some post-ups, getting stuff around the rim was key for me. And then, you know, we just kept it going and played really, really well.
Any other questions?
Yeah, so I've got one for Blake, actually. So when Doc took this job here, I mean, one of his big philosophies always is, you know, kind of not to put a ton of emphasis on the offensive glass, and I think it reflects in your guys' overall rebounding numbers, but do you feel like you guys are a good rebounding team and have been a good rebounding team over the past few years?
We've been solid. You know, I think sometimes that we rely on DJ too much, you know, myself included. I think sometimes you kind of take it for granted that he's going to get the rebound, but, you know, as a team, I think we need to do a better job of crashing the glass and making it a team thing.
Against these guys, how big of a priority was that, and how often was that talked about in the last couple of days?
Every single day. It was a big point of emphasis, and it still will be. They're a great offensive, they're a great rebounding team. And, you know, Ed Davis alone is averaging like 5-6 offensive rebounds against us. So, you know, making sure we keep those guys off the glass is a big thing. You know, they crash every time they play so hard that you always have to account for them.
I guess probably the most you've attacked the rim since you've been back. I know you wanted to play as much as you could coming back, 5 games I think you had. How cognizant are you of, I need to save some of this to be ready for the postseason versus I want to be in as good a rhythm as I can be as you're going to make?
It was a little bit of both. I think, you know, I wanted to play good minutes, decent minutes to get ready. But at the same time, you know, the stretch run the last 5 games is all about preparing for the playoffs. So it was a little bit of both, but I think that's, you know, it is why I didn't play in, you know, Utah and in Phoenix. But you know, like I said, I felt pretty good today. So as long as I keep taking steps forward, I'm happy.
Martin,
knowing how eager you and your team have been, you know, anticipating getting the playoffs going, and then you have a real nice 20-point win to start it. How satisfied are you with what happened tonight?
Pretty satisfied, but you know, it's one win. And like I said, I think the best thing about it is we executed on the points that we wanted to execute on. There's obviously some things that we can clean up and things we can get better at, but I thought for the most part we really did everything we wanted to do. Most of the things we wanted to do, but like I said, still areas to improve.
Last two. Blake, the dunks you had, the above the rim plays that you had, how big is that for you, just showing to Rebecca, showing that, you know, physically you're back and in the type of shape that you want to be for this postseason run?
You know, my body-wise, strength and all that feels pretty good. You know, endurance and all that feels pretty good. It's just, you know, little stuff and stuff that you might not be able to see, but stuff that I feel. So as far as, you know, how I feel around the basket and exploding and all that, I felt fine. But there's just always things to improve upon as far as timing and making up for lost time.
Last one,
anyway? Yeah, Blake, there's a lot being made, obviously, about how long it's going to take you to get back to being you, but the silver lining and missing those games and having all that rest, you might be one of, you know, in the Western Conference playoffs right now, one of the stars that's coming in who has, you know, the most rest leading in and can hit his peak in the playoffs.
Yeah, I've heard a lot about it. I'm just going to go play and play as hard as I can and fill any void that we see as a team, so I'm not really worried about the, you know, the whole can you get back or really you know, be able to play at a high level. It's just about filling those gaps for our team and finding ways to help.
All right, thank you, everybody.